5552 or email pilotclub@up.edu today. Fans will find team rosters and game notes available in the Child Center lobby. The Child Center concession stand is open in the main lobby with a variety of snacks and beverages. For all the latest information about Portland Pilots Athletics, including the latest scores, stats, video, game schedule, player profile, and game highlights, log on to PortlandPilots.com. At this time, we would like to thank the following generous partners for their support of Pilot Athletics. Nike, Coca-Cola, U.S. Bank, Portland North Marriott, Lunchbox Tires, and Northwest Navigator. Now's the best time to become a Portland Pilot basketball season ticket holder. Put your seats down and don't miss any of the action. Visit PortlandPilots.com/ticket. Call the Pilot box office at 503-943-GO-UP for more information. University of Portland and the National Conference promotes good sportsmanship by student-athletes, coaches, and spectators. We request your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. Profanity, racial or sexist comments, or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student-athletes, coaches, or team representatives will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the site of competition. Thank you for your cooperation and assistance. Thank you. willingness to serve and sacrifice for the common good. The University of Portland extends its heartfelt gratitude to all those that have served and continue to serve in protecting our great freedoms. Now please direct your attention to the court where the University of Portland Army ROTC Color Guard presents the colors for the playing of the national anthem.
Basketball fans, and welcome onto the Bluff for the start of the 2020 basketball season as UC San Diego makes the trip north to take on the Portland Pilots to open up the season. I'm Brian Slyke. I'm joined by my friend and broadcast partner Jennifer Mountain, and we'll have your call. The Tritons are playing in their second season at the Division I level after being very successful at the Division II level. Meanwhile, the Pilots, they're opening up at home and looking to build off of back-to-back winning seasons. Lots of new players on both sides, some familiar with the Pilots, but Jen, what are you looking for in tonight's contest?
You know, I expect 40 minutes of pressure basketball, high-quality offense. Both teams have multiple weapons that they can go to on the floor, and this game's going to come down to who's going to make defensive stops.
The Tritons, they're a younger squad. They're going to rely on Sydney Brown to lead the way, and she's our player to watch for UC San Diego tonight.
Yeah, senior forward. She was a second-team All-Big West selection last year. Super versatile. Coach Vandeveer relies on her to do a lot for this squad. She averaged almost 15 points a game, 9 rebounds last year. She's got to be a factor for them to have success today.
Some may say that the Tritons are in some deep water in today's contest, but what are the keys for the Tritons to get a victory inside the Child Center?
Well, the first thing they need to do is take care of the basketball and control tempo. They got to do a good job on Andrews and Fowler. Coach talked about defensive discipline and then matching the intensity that Portland is going to bring and how hard they play.
Meanwhile, let's take a look at the home player to watch, and nobody's done a better job in such a short amount of time than Alex Fowler.
She is a tremendous player, WCC All-Conference player who's a tough matchup for every opponent that comes in the building. She can play inside out. She's expanded her range. She has guard skills for a post. Quite frankly, she's just super talented in all facets of the game, and Portland needs her to dominate inside tonight and be that floor leader that she's come to know.
Well, the Pilots still thinking about last season, trying to build on it, but how do they get the win tonight and start their season off with a W?
First thing they want to do is defend the three-point line. I mean, that's been a big, you know, thing that Coach Meek has really talked about. And then find a good rhythm and good rotation tonight. That's one of his goals as a coaching staff. And then the last one, and I think is probably the biggest key, is they have to be a better rebounding team, especially from the guard position.
Well, the coaching staff for both sides. We've got Michael Meek leading the way for the Pilots. He's in his third season. He's done a terrific job in leading the Pilots in back-to-back winning seasons, something that hasn't happened in over a decade for the Pilots.
Yeah, I mean, he's come in and built a great culture so far. These girls have bought in. They have great team chemistry. You know, we talked to him the other day, and he's talking about this group, and he thinks it could be the potentially or the best group they've had on campus so far. And you know, we've seen some really good pieces so far. It's so early in the season. They've had a few injuries here and there, but they, in my opinion, have the pieces to finish in the top part of the league.
You just saw a smile on his face. Don't get used to it too often. Very intense on the bench. Meanwhile, for UC San Diego, it's Heidi Vanderveer. And if you're familiar with the name Vanderveer, that's a basketball family right there, Jen.
Well, obviously Tara's sister, but she's coached at so many levels. I mean, WNBA coach for 12 years in a couple different places. She's been in San Francisco. She's been at Occidental. She's been successful at UCSD for quite a while. And you know, they've just made the jump to Division One, and you know, I think they're ready. And I think, you know, she's, when we talked to her the other day, she really talked about this team actually being pretty good by the end of the season.
Let's get you the starting lineups for both sides. And looking at both teams right there, out there for UC San Diego, it's gonna be Julia Makabuhai, Aisha Brown, Madison Baxter, Sydney Brown, and Brianna Claros. For the Pilots, Emmy Shear getting the start after sitting out in that exhibition game. Haley Andrews, Alex Fowler, Maddie Molheim also out there. And then the player we've been trying to look forward or trying to watch for the last couple weeks, that's Lucy Cochran.
I'm super excited to see what she brings, not only just in the post, but the combination of her and Alex Fowler together. I mean, Coach Meek talked about how great a passer she is. And I just think that's going to open up so many things for Fowler and the other guards, quite frankly, on the perimeter. So it's just something I've been looking forward to for a while.
UC San Diego in the Navy uniforms, UC in yellow, San Diego in white across the chest. Meanwhile, the Portland Pilots coming out in their white uniforms, Portland in purple across the chest, last names across their back. And Alex Fowler used to stepping in the middle circle. Got to step aside for Lucy Cochran this time.
Yeah, definitely something that she's not used to.
It'll be Cochran and Brown for the jump ball. And the basketball season officially underway in the Child Center as the Pilots win the opening tip. Fowler from the elbow. Defensive rebound, San Diego. Loader looked to be partially blocked. And some miscommunication right there, Shear and Andrews.
Nice little footwork there to keep it in bounds, though. Good job, Andrews, by just being smart, heads-up play.
We talked about the passing of Cochran. Got a pass down low to Emmy Shear.
And you're going to see that a lot, where Portland looks to post their guards up quite a bit. And again, out in that 2-3 matchup that they play, it's going to be super important for UC San Diego to really move the basketball to get open looks.
Brown with it. Over to Sydney Brown. Kicks it out to Makabuhai. Off the mark on the three-pointer.
We're going to see that a lot tonight. She can shoot the three. All of them can shoot the three. That's one thing Vanderveer, Coach Vanderveer said, is she's got a lot of kids that can score.
And there's the all-WCC first team member, Alex Fowler, right there on the low block.
And I like to see that right off the bat. She's going inside and posting up.
And that was something that Coach Meek had talked about, using the inside presence more.
Well, and with this lineup, they certainly can. And, you know, both of them can go to the perimeter and have success. So it's a tandem, you know, duo that really can hurt a lot of people.
Almost 2 minutes in, Pilots leading 2-0. Again, feeding Fowler down low, and it's tough to stop her when she's that far underneath.
Well, anytime you're given a post player, especially at this talent level, you know, a five-footer with somebody on her back down low, you gotta give her the ball.
Brown drives, comes up short, Cochran with the rebound. Feeding Fowler, streaking up the court.
So far, Portland's done a great job of rebounding the basketball defensively, which then starts their transition break, which is something they really want to do, is get out and run.
Foul called on Emmy Shear. That'll be her first and the team's first. And Maisie Burnham will now check in for Shearer.
I mean, the thing that's so tremendous for Coach Meek is that he's got so much depth. And people coming in, you know, there's not a drop-off. It's somebody coming in with different abilities, and he's got a lot of players that can contribute.
Now there's a size matchup in the paint. Alex Obufege checking in. 12 on the shot clock. Cueros to Obufege at the elbow, off the mark.
And one thing that Coach Vandeer talked about yesterday is just getting quality shots in the half court and not taking too quick of shots. And right now, Portland's making them go a little bit faster than they want.
Burnham missing the three. Fowler tried to go for the rebound. It'll get called over the back of Julia Makabuhai.
That's what you call a blockout. That's a great job of putting a body on somebody. You know, obviously a huge size disadvantage and just smart.
Fowler's first, team second foul. Liana Kaituu checking in. There was the substitution horn, but now she'll stay at the scorer's table. And Alex will head to the bench.
Great start for Fowler. I mean, you know, picked up the early one there, but she'll be back in no problem here in the next little bit.
Yeah, she had all 6 points for the Pilots. Portland putting on the full court pressure. Andrews on defense. Obufege rips down the offensive board, keeping it alive, and a carry called.
Well, so far, what I've seen, UC San Diego's done a nice job of handling the press. And a lot of teams that come here, that pressure, automatically there's turnovers. They haven't had turnovers. It's they're going a little bit quick in the half court and not getting the shots maybe they're used to.
That sort of falls into the second part. Oh, great backdoor cut to Cochran, and the touch underneath. But I was going to say, that's sort of like the two-headed monster of the press, is you can either force a turnover or you force the other team to move too quickly.
Exactly. And that's got to feel good for Cochran. I mean, she hasn't played for a while.
And a turnover by the Tritons. Rose Flew going to check in along with Keely Frawley. And you're right, Cochran was a transfer that had already committed to Portland, but because of what was happening with COVID, never made it stateside for the season. And so we've known about her presence for a while. It's just nice to finally see her out on the court in the purple and white.
For sure. I mean, transfer from Oregon. She's got great size and her passing ability and just the ability to score. I expect her to, you know, do really good things in this conference.
Cochran was looking to pass and a foul called. Fluke was fighting for position in the paint. And that foul will be on number 15, Brianna Cueros.
Well, you're going to see multiple Portland guards posting up. And then, you know, if you're not jumping to the ball defensively and you get yourself stuck, you're going to give up easy baskets or get called for a foul like they just did.
The inbound, Burnham in the paint. A couple of defenders around her, goes in and out. Brown. Gives up the Cueros. Over to Montgomery on the wing. Now Brown near the baseline, puts up the short two. Ripped down on the offensive board by Obufege. Another offensive rebound. Brown fouled. Correction, travel call. Now three turnovers for San Diego.
Just all in the half court. I mean, that's one thing I'm going to give them credit. They're doing a nice job of beating the press and the pressure. They've just got to settle down offensively.
Kaituu kicks it out to Burnham. Uses her body to go baseline, stuffed. Montgomery's shoe falls off. She's trailing behind. Obufege, high off the glass, no good. Flug, the skip pass to Burnham on the near wing. Cochran in trouble, three defenders on her and a foul called. Pilots will get it underneath, this one called on Parker Montgomery. That'll be her first personal and the second one on UC San Diego.
Good job of keeping that ball into play for her. Burnham kind of put her in a bad spot with that guard coming over and double teaming her. She's got to be aware of that in that backside.
You get another look at it.
A lot of hands in there.
Fowler checks back into the game along with Moheim. Kaitu'u with it, feeding Fowler. The give and go ends up in a turnover. Sydney Brown going up against Flug. The step and no, still denied.
They are having opportunities, they're just not finishing offensively. Just got to get them to settle down here.
Pilots working with an 8-0 lead. Kaitu'u driving into the paint, got the defender to go by and kicks it back out. 10 on the shot clock. Flug, free throw line, jumper in. And the first points on the season for her.
And I've been impressed with her. I think she, you know, fought a few injuries last year, and she's come in good shape, good attitude. And coach talked about her in practice just being tremendous.
Well, foul called on the Pilots, and that'll bring us to our first media break. The Pilots jumping out to a 10-0 lead over UC San Diego. We'll be right back on the WCC Network. Welcome back inside the Child Center. The Portland Pilots leading 10-0 over UC San Diego. Brian Slyke and Jennifer Mountain with your call. And UC San Diego, they've had some opportunities, but right now 0-for-10 from the floor. Brown giving it up to Sydney Brown and blocked by Alex Fowler. Brown has it, she's on the ground. Flug causing troubles, forcing the turnover. Trapped in the corner. Pilots need to bail her out, Fowler's there.
And what a luxury to have your post player that can come back and handle the basketball. And you're right, Brian, they've had a lot of opportunities to score. They just haven't had anything fall. And I'm sure Coach Vandeveer talked about just settling down offensively, getting good looks at the rim.
Mohan, the three-point specialist. Nothing but net. And Coach Vandeveer going to call a timeout after that triple from Mohan, the first one of the season. It's 13-0 Pilots on the WCC Network. Welcome back inside the Child Center. 3:49 left to go in the first quarter, and right now the Pilots pitching a shutout.
Number 12, Madison Baxter.
And almost forcing a turnover on the inbound. And there, the pressure from the Pilots forcing UC San Diego to do too much in the backcourt.
And that's really the first turnover, you know, versus the press that they've had. She just kind of took her eyes off the ball here, but Coach Vandeveer, I'm sure at the timeout, just again telling them to settle down and just defensive assignments. Got to be smart about not giving up threes.
Andrews posting up Baxter. Short on that shot. Ooh, a Chamberlain, the rebound brings it up for UC San Diego. And a blocking call on Haley Andrews. That'll be her first personal, the fourth on the Pilots.
That was close.
And I like the idea. She was trying to cut off the sideline.
Yeah, she's moving. That's a good call.
Chamberlain. The Claras. Back to Chamberlain.
Right now, again, Portland in that matchup zone, just causing trouble. They're not getting clean looks with ball movement.
Six on the shot clock. Brown has it near the elbow. Shearer on defense. Gives it up to Sydney Brown. Off the glass, no good. Going for the offensive rebound. And they're going to say Sydney Brown was on the end line. So it'll be Pilot basketball.
Returning for the Pilots, number 30, Lucy Cochran.
Lucy Cochran checking in, along with Julia Makabuhai for UC San Diego.
Also checking in, number 20, Izzy Forsyth.
Looks like they're going to extend their pressure a little bit.
Pilot 6 of 12 shooting here in the first quarter. Backdoor cut to Andrews. Too strong. Fowler went up for the rebound.
Well, you don't see Andrews miss too many of those. She's kind of not a lot of body control right there, but that's something they try to do a ton as a little backdoor option for her.
Isha Brown, her first 13
shot. I feel like we're more used to seeing her use the glass in that type of situation.
Yep.
Fowler quickly underneath. And it looks like they called a foul. They did on Izzy Forsyth, freshman from Vancouver, British Columbia.
Yeah, a little late whistle there, but great heads up plays out of bounds. Again, they do such a great job of executing. And just defense right there wasn't quite ready and just a little snuck that pass. Andrew snuck that pass for her on a little bunny shot.
Fowler missing the first free throw. Last year, she shot 69.4% from the stripe. Nice even 14 now for the Pilots as they lead 14 to nothing. Forsyth in trouble. Picks up her dribble. Brown going up against Cochran. She's got the speed advantage, and Shearer looked like she might have picked up the foul on Aisha Brown. And she did. That'll be her second personal and the fifth one on the Pilots.
Good take there by her. I mean, literally, I think for 25... Sorry, for 15 seconds, they had everybody in the 10-foot line and above.
Maisie Burnham checking in. Shearer to the bench. Baxter to the bench for UC San Diego. And Alex Obufege checking in for UC San Diego. Brown with the first point of the season now for the Tritons. Took almost 7.5 minutes.
Took the lid off.
2 for 2 from the stripe. Andrews underneath and turnover.
I think she needed to take that up on her own.
Chamberlain puts up a three, back iron. Burnham, the long rebound.
Well, Ula can shoot it. I had an opportunity to coach her in the Oregon Washington All-Star game, and the kid can really shoot the basketball.
Cochran, the feed to Fowler underneath, and that's the passing that Coach Meek talked about, what he really likes from Cochran, and you can basically run the offense through her at the top of the key.
Yeah, I mean, it's going to be such a weapon with the two of them on the floor. mean, you got two bigs that really perimeter inside out. They can pretty much do everything.
16-2. Cochran off the side of the backboard. Chamberlain going against Burnham. 1:30 left to go in the first quarter.
And probably the one thing that she's got to work on in the next little bit is just getting stronger.
Aisha Brown, strong on that shot attempt, and Ogbufeghe was the last one to touch it. Pilot basketball.
And right there, you just see the intimidation factor. You know, instead of just laying that up like normal, they're, you know, the fear of getting blocked or whatever. And, you know, those are shots that I can't imagine typically they miss.
Checking in is Bridget Mullings and Sydney Brown for UC San Diego. Rose Pflug checked in for the Pilots. Pflug fighting for position now against Makabuhai. Picks up her dribble, out to Andrews. Andrews spins inside and the finish.
She's just so strong and smart.
Sid Brown goes baseline, spins back into the court, and drops the first official basket for UC San Diego. First 2 points came off of free throws.
Well, she's competing hard. I'm glad that one dropped for her because she's been going to the rim hard. That's a good job of just making a move and taking it right at the big.
About 6 seconds between the shot clock and the game clock. Screen by Fowler. Andrews, the hesitation, the take, finish, and one.
She's just so deceiving. It's like, is she going to pass? It's a little hesitation. She's just really, really got that down. And nice little scoop shot for the finish.
And it's almost like she baited the defender that was on Fowler to go towards her, and that just opened up enough of a window for the take.
Absolutely.
4 points, 3 assists already for Andrews. Last year led the league in scoring during conference play, 16.2 points, and led the conference in assists at 5.8 assists per game. That actually ranks top 10 in returning players this season in all of Division I.
Well, when you look at the stats real quick, you know, they got 14 points in the paint. It's a pretty good start.
They've got they seem to have the positioning underneath and can't really be stopped. As Brown with it, goes baseline, kicks it out to Makabuhai. The three, long and no good, air ball. And the Pilots will take a 21-4 lead into the second quarter. We'll be right back on the WCC Network. Welcome back inside the Child Center. Start of the second quarter, a 21-4 lead for the Portland Pilots. And it all starts inside for UP. And Jen, you talked about it just before we headed to break. The points in the paint, 14-2 in favor of Portland.
Absolutely. 14 of their 21 points, and that was one of their emphasis right from the get-go. And it's not just post players, it's guards. You know, and once that happens, it's going to open up the perimeter shooting, which is also a strong suit of theirs.
The one positive for UC San Diego you can look at, they grabbed five offensive boards to get some second chance opportunities as Sidney Brown connects on the first shot of the second quarter.
I think, you know, they came in probably a little nervous, just got to settle down and just, you know, do what they do and not try to do too much.
Kaitu went off glass, no good. And it'll be UC San Diego. Brianna Claros checking into the bench is Izzy Forsyth. Claros, when UC San Diego was still at the Division II level, was the CCAA Freshman of the Year in the entire state of California. She takes it into the paint here, dishes it off, blocked by Cochran.
And dish, just a tremendous play by Cochran inside.
Burnham with position, kicks it out to Kaitu'u, deflection on the pass, put up the three, Brown comes down with a rebound. And a foul on Maisie Burnham.
Maybe just a little too quick offensively for Portland. Not that she doesn't have that range, but I think Coach Meek might like to see a little bit more ball swing.
Of course, Kaitu'u coming off of knee surgery a couple of seasons ago and was wearing a knee brace for a lot of the season last year. Now she's gotten more comfortable with it and without the brace, and now she seems to be back to her old self.
Yeah, you know, once you kind of get past that point and get rid of that brace, the confidence level just changes.
Beautiful feed from Claros, but Brown can't finish. Kelsey Lindsay bringing the ball up for the Pilots, her first action. And Kaitu'u, 3 second call in the paint.
3 second.
It's only Portland's third turnover tonight.
Well, that's been a point of emphasis for him and talking with his squad, especially back-to-back turnovers.
Brown with it on the wing. Got some separation, put up the three off the glass, no good. Offensive rebound by Mullings. Foul called on the ground. And that'll be another one on Maisie Burnham.
And Coach Vander, that's an absolutely what she was talking about, is going too fast. I mean, they did a nice job getting the ball up the floor, and then no ball movement whatsoever, just pulled a three, and just not a good shot.
Burnham comes out with foul trouble, picking up her second. Second one on the Pilots in this quarter. Flug checks in.
You know, the style of play from Portland, the pressure that you're going to get every time you come in here, it's hard to, you know, explain or practice, because you're not going to see it at practice every day. And so, again, if it doesn't turn it over, it's making somebody go too fast, and that's exactly what they're doing right now.
Montgomery made that last bucket for UC San Diego. Fade away on the baseline. Andrews has it, 12 on the shot clock. Montgomery on defense. And a foul called on Montgomery. That'll be her second personal. And the first one on the Tritons in this quarter.
Super smart by Andrews. She knew that she was going to get that call. Just waited it out, and too much body contact.
Andrews loses it momentarily. Picks up her dribble, gives it up to Cochran. Kaitu'u, and Sidney Brown breaks up the pass and forcing the turnover.
And that was a good call by the official. Went off her knee. Just gotta go get that ball no matter what. Don't let it go.
Courtney Thompson will check in, or check the ball in. Claros going up against Lindsay. Brown with it to Chamberlain. Out to Claros, top of the key. 15 on the shot clock. Thompson puts up the three, rattles in and out. Brown offensive board. Chamberlain missing. Another offensive rebound. Fighting for it on the ground. Lindsay's down there along with Lucy Cochran. And it'll be Portland basketball as Alex Fowler checks in.
Well, great job of competing right there. I mean, they're extremely aggressive. They're going through the boards really hard, trying to get second opportunities. And then that 50-50 call, getting on the ground, that's one thing she talked about, is she wanted to match the intensity level in which Portland plays.
Thompson picking up full court pressure on Lindsay. Almost 3 minutes have gone by here in the second quarter. Pilots looking for their first points. Fowler goes up and fouled by Sydney Brown.
I like that. They've done that a couple times now, just kind of cleared her from the high post and let her go, a little high post drive, and she definitely has the ball skills and the strength to get to the rim. You know, and Lindsay coming at the point guard spot really, you know, gives a chance for Andrews to get a little bit of a breather, because that's somebody they're going to need a lot of minutes from throughout the whole season.
10 points now for Fowler after making that last free throw. And Fowler, the fastest player in UP history to reach 1,000 points in 58 games, which surpassed Andrews, who did it in 72 earlier last season.
Both of them tremendous players.
And both strong all-around players. You talked about it briefly, but the ability for Fowler to come back into the court, get the ball, dribble it up. I mean, and then she's going to post down low. That's what Andrews does as well.
I mean, they're totally two different body types, and they both play inside out a little bit. You know, they're just tremendous, and they're a great duo together, man. They feed off each other really, really well. And, you know, I think Fowler could actually be player of the year in the conference if she continues to play well throughout the year.
Remember, that was something that we talked about a couple of years ago in her freshman season. We knew that she would probably be the newcomer of the year, which she was, and in some contention for possible player of the year in the conference.
Well, and the one thing that I really am looking forward to, and I've already seen it so far, is her leadership on the floor. We talked about it, you know, in some interviews earlier, and she's really taken initiative to be that leader.
Maddie Moheim taking it to the hoop. And talking with her this summer, that was a facet of her game that she really wanted to work on, not just being a three-point specialist, but be able to take it to the hoop.
Exactly, because that's what everybody's playing her for, is that three-point shot.
Cochran comes in with the block, and Fowler with the lead pass to Moheim turns it over. With the bench up and excited on the block from Lucy Cochran.
Well, that's an area that they really haven't had, a shot blocker. You know, you got her sitting in the paint with those long arms and wingspan, and great timing, to be honest with you. She can move. You know, that's going to add another dimension that they haven't had in the past.
Here's another look at it.
Great block. Great timing.
And you talked about that reach. Got it all the way up there. Floros in trouble. Double teamed. Makabuhai with it. Dribbles in the paint. Floater. And it falls.
She's a crafty little guard. She's got that little runner, little poise. I like it.
In her All-American season in the last year at Division II for UC San Diego, averaged 17.6 points. Flug, the triple. Rebound UC San Diego, pocket picked. The feed to Cochran. She can't convert it for two.
Going to a little four out, one in, trying to isolate at the high post, spread him out.
Brown cuts in from behind. Cochran, rebound. Almost could have been a travel. And transition buckets for the Pilots. Chris passing all the way around. Chamberlain tries to find Brown in the corner, turnover. .16 left to go in the second quarter. And it's 17-point lead right now for Portland. At one point, they were up 14-0 to start the game. The Fowler puts up a three, no good, gets her own offensive rebound. Flug off the mark there.
And so to me, right there, that offensive possession, not good shots. I mean, they can get those shots anytime. Little ball movement, on-ball stuff, and get the defense to shift. And I don't think Coach Meeks is going to like those two shots.
Well, 4:59 left to go in the second quarter. That leads us to our immediate break. It's 27-10. The Pilots are leading, and Lucy Cochran is making quite a name for herself in a short amount of time here on the Bluff. Welcome back inside the Child Center. Just under 5 minutes left to go until halftime. The Pilots working with a 17-point lead over UC San Diego. Five on the shot clock. Andrews gives it up to Emily Sewell. Her first action, two on the shot clock. Flug puts it up. Offensive rebound, Portland. And Burnham fouled on the shot.
Well, great job of getting the shot off. Just knowing the shot clock was going to expire. And a good offensive board. And good finish, got herself to the free throw line.
Cindy Brown picked up that foul. That'll be her first personal and the third one on UC San Diego. Maisie Burnham at the line. Big Sky, freshman of the year last season.
And she's a nice addition to them. Fits the system really well, just the kind of kid that she is. And she's gonna have a lot of success in this program.
Almost an 80% free throw shooter last season. Averaged 14.3 points and 5.5 rebounds for the Eagles. Kai Tu'u, no good. Sewell, rebound. Out to Flug, another three opportunity. Can't cash in. Baxter comes in for the rebound. Poked away by Kai Tu'u.
Great hands, just a lot of pressure. Hands up, handsy with the basketball. You just can't be sloppy.
Pilots just one of their last eight shooting. Burnham fighting for position on the block. It looks like Makabuhai. Correction, it'll be number 15, Brianna Claros. Emily Sewell checking out, and Lucy Cochran checking in.
Well, really smart on the offensive side of Portland at throwing and posting up those guards. You know, definite size advantage, and whether it's a cut or just literally walking themselves to the block and getting position, it was just a heads-up play.
Kaylee Frawley checking in. Rose Flug heads to the bench. Burnham back at the line, sinks the free throw. Three for three from the stripe and a couple of rebounds. Now she's got 4 points. 31-10, Pilots lead.
Well, the thing that's so dangerous about Portland is they have you know, nine people on any given night that can put up double figures. And, I mean, gosh, that's a pretty nice luxury to have as a coach.
Well, you and I talked about it in past games, but that's kind of been their Achilles heel, is where were they going to get that third scoring option? And that was something that they missed since Kate Anderson was there 2 seasons ago.
Well, they definitely have solved that problem because they've got multiple weapons. You know, and that becomes a scout problem. Like, people can't prepare the way they used to for them.
Out to Kai Tu'u, steps behind the three-point line, drains it.
Nice driving kick right there. Got her feet set, knew where the three-point line is, and she's got that range.
UC San Diego, 4 turnovers in the last 3 minutes. Andrews almost caused another one. Makabuhai, floater. Makabuhai. 20-point lead for Portland. 3 minutes to go until halftime. Burnham with it. Over to Andrews. Crowley with it on the far wing. Kai Tu'u going up against Brown. Gives it up to Cochran in the paint. Thought she had a step. The shot, no good. Burnham, offensive rebound, denied by the bottom of the backboard. Makabuhai quickly down the court, lost control.
That's where Andrews' strength just took over right there.
Goes baseline. Pilot swinging around. Kai Tu'u off the mark.
Good extra pass.
Burnham! The take and one.
And that's what she's going to bring. Offensive boards, defensive pressure, athleticism, both ends. I mean, she can do it, and she can score the basketball. Got herself an and one.
Number 23. Courtney Thompson at number 32.
And I want to say that's either the second or third offensive rebound that she's had. And it's those little things that give you an extra possession, an extra shot that will make the difference. I mean, we talked with Coach Meek, and looking back at that 2019-2020 season and the amount of games they won by just a single possession, I mean, that goes such a long way for this club.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, the little things. And the focus on not turning the ball over like you talked about the other day, I think it's going to be crucial down the road for tournament, you know, chances.
Triton's in trouble. And Thompson. And the Triton's call timeout, 37-14. And we'll keep it here. But right now, the Pilots have done a good job of forcing pressure, getting the turnovers right now, because they forced 12 turnovers, turned that into 13 points as they lead by 23 right now.
Absolutely, and especially at the beginning of the game. I mean, they took UC San Diego out of their flow and what they were doing, made them take shots that were uncharacteristic, at least from what I've seen. And, you know, right there, like that pass, you know, you can't catch that ball so close to the baseline. It allows Portland to put you right into a trap. And, you know, that's why Coach Vander had to call that quick timeout just to bail her out so they don't turn the ball over. They've settled down this second quarter here and got some better opportunities to score. They've gone 4 out, 1 in and looked to penetrate a little bit, and they've had some success. Just got to make sure that they take care of the basketball and make quality shots.
And the Pilots, it just seemed like they've been able to get away with just about anything that they want to do. They've only forced four turnovers, or they've only had 4 turnovers, I should say, on themselves. And that was a big point of emphasis, because the last couple of seasons, it seems like they'd force a turnover, then immediately give it up. Shear takes it away on the inbound, and they're going to call a charge.
That was close to being in the restricted circle.
That is Shear's third foul.
Nope, she was out.
Yeah, Montgomery had about a half step out of that circle. Of course, I just had to open up my mouth for another turnover. Brown over to Forsythe. Long. And if you're familiar with the name Forsythe, her sister Louise played at Gonzaga for the last couple of seasons. Cochran underneath.
And I like what they did right there. You know, she's had a couple opportunities to score where she's, you know, taken a high post drive or made a move and fallen away from the basket. That's what they need her to do.
Thompson running into trouble, going backwards, and Forsythe able to get it across the timeline. And the Pilots just causing all sorts of trouble defensively. Offensive rebound for Thompson. Full side, but Flute goes by and the block from Cochran. And a foul called.
Well, Rose missed that closeout for sure, but you know that's where you have the benefit of having Cochran right behind you to pick that block up.
Forsyth with the foul. That'll be her first personal. But the seventh on UC San Diego, so that's two shots for Portland.
At the line for the Pilots, number two, Rose Flug. For two.
Flug shooting 60% from the free throw line last season. In their exhibition game against Willamette. And an assist, a rebound, and a steal.
And Coach Meek, when we talked to him the other day, I mean, he's really been pleased with her in practice, playing really well. And, you know, he's like, it just hasn't transferred into games and scrimmages yet. He goes, but she's got it in her, and she's been tremendous for them this season so far.
Well, he was pretty honest with her coming into the season. Like, we've got some talented players coming in. You know, how hard are you going to set yourself up for success? As Burnham, again, fighting down low, gets the bucket, and she now has 9 points. But Flug took that to heart, got in shape, got ready to go for the season, and it's shown right here. Montgomery falling to the ground. And they will call that one on Rose Flug. That'll be her second personal and the fifth on the Pilots.
Just got herself caught out of position. And again, you know, you watch and look at what UC San Diego is doing, is they're doing a decent job of getting it in the half court. They're just going too fast.
Burnham went to the bench, Frawley out. Kaitu'u also comes off the bench. Fowler checks out. Fowler leading all scorers with 11 points as Montgomery making the free throw. Montgomery, sophomore from Porter Ranch, California. Father played football at Oregon State. Turnover by the Pilots on the inbound. Brown in the paint, kicks it out. Montgomery's feeling it. Short on the three, Flug, long rebound. Cross court pass to Lindsay, near wing, puts up the three, that's short. Cochran in trouble. Finds Frawley, with quick passing from the Pilots, Lindsay puts it up. Thompson. Met by Lindsay, and that'll be Kelsey Lindsay's first personal foul, and the sixth one on the Pilots.
I don't mind that three there. You know, the ball had gone up, rebound, Cochran, nice pass, you know, back out to the perimeter. She didn't have an opportunity to score, and then a nice kick for the next three. You know, missed the shot, but those sometimes off offensive boards, kicking it out to the three, those are great opportunities to score.
Michael Buhai with the make.
You know, I'm looking at the stat sheet here, and you've got eight people already that have scored for Portland. And that's just, we're talking about that depth. He's just got so many people that can come in and contribute.
No field goals in almost 3 minutes for UC San Diego. 30 seconds until half, 42-18. The Pilots lead. Back door to Cochran. Got the defender to go by. Cochran's now got 6 points. Full court pressure put on by the Pilots. Kaitu'u swats it out of the air. There's gotta be a 10-second call. And there it is. The suffocating defense from the Portland Pilots forcing another turnover.
I mean, absolutely great pressure in all areas. And, you know, you gotta give them credit. I mean, they're playing just as hard as they are right now from the start. I mean, big lead, not letting up whatsoever. And, you know, you expect them to take the last shot and being smart.
9.2 seconds. Luke gets it into Cochran. And Montgomery tried to take it away. 4 seconds left. 2 seconds. Montgomery has it. Chucks it up. And that'll end up just short with the Pilots working with a 44-18 lead in gender. Quick thoughts on the first half.
Well, I thought their defensive pressure was tremendous. It not only caused turnovers, but it made them go too fast. Took them right out of what they want to do offensively. And then offensively, honestly, they've really been able to do whatever they've wanted and scored in multiple areas. And he's going to have that weapon, those kind of weapons with the depth that he has on the floor.
And that's what's led to a 26-point lead for the Pilots. They're leading 44-18. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be back to recap the first half in just a few minutes.
One.
Welcome back inside the Child Center. Just 5 minutes before halftime is up and the second half is underway. It's a 44-18 point lead for the Pilots. I'm Brian Syke, joined by Jennifer Mountain. Let's take a look at some of the first half stats between these two teams. And right now, UC San Diego, you look at their shooting percentage right now, not great. They started out 0-for-12 from the floor. Rebounding is about even, but then you look at the assist category for Portland, and they've done a good job of moving that ball around.
Well, I mean, it's the field goal percentage. I mean, it's the type of shots that are happening, and, you know, if you're shooting below 20% from the game, you're going to have a hard time competing.
And one of the big stars in that first half for the Pilots was a newcomer, somebody we've been waiting to see play for the Pilots for about a season and a half now. It's Lucy Cochran. She's got 6 points, 5 rebounds, 2 assists, and 2 blocks all in the first half.
You know, I was really excited to see her play and did not disappoint. I mean, the combination of her and Fowler inside is going to just open up things for Portland. I thought she did a nice job. She has a really nice job of timing right there. You saw the block, and she can move. She's athletic. I think Portland did a nice job of actually creating some shots for her, you know, a little back screen action. And, you know, she's got the height, obviously, to finish down low.
What is something you'd like to see the Pilots take advantage of in the second half to extend this lead and then eventually, you know, leave here with a victory?
Well, to be honest with you, I mean, we were kind of talking about it. They really can do anything they want right now. I love the fact that they've scored a lot of points in the paint. They've gotten a lot of people involved. I think there's 9 people on the roster that have scored in the half. Again, that goes to the depth that they have off the bench scoring. Just smarter shots at times, I think, would be the only thing that they need to work on and shoot better from the three-point line, maybe more quality shots.
And you talk about the scoring between everybody else on the Pilots right now. Another surprise or a pleasant surprise is Maisie Burnham. She's put up 9 points in that first half, the former Big West, Big Sky, Player of the Year. And she's done a nice job fitting in this lineup.
Oh, for sure. I mean, she's a great player. You know, she's Big Sky Freshman of the Year for a reason. You know, she's athletic, she can score, and she can do a little bit of everything, and she's making a lot happen at the defensive end. And, you know, like Coach Mike said, she's a perfect fit for his system.
Pirates are leading 44-18, just 2.5 minutes until the second half. We'll be right back on the WCC Network. Welcome back onto the Bluff. Inside the Child Center, Brian Slyke and Jennifer Mountain with your call. It's a 44-18 lead right now for the Portland Pilots. And really, the Pilots have just been taking care of business down low in the paint. I mean, that's where they've gotten a majority of their points, 26 of their 44. And they've just done a nice job of executing. And I think Coach Meek has to be pleased with how the offense has run. Hasn't been the most efficient from outside, but everything else seems to be going their way.
No, absolutely. I think he's going to be pretty happy with that half. I mean, bring that three-point shooting percentage up a little bit, you know, and it's a pretty darn good half. Scoring 44 points and a half, you know, they're on pace for a nice night. So I think he's going to be pretty happy. And again, you know, don't fix it. It's not broke, right? So just go back to some of the same things they were doing in that first half and make things happen.
Starters are out there for the Pilots. It's Moheim, Andrews, Shearer, Cochran, and Fowler. We've got Baxter, Quaros, Montgomery, Sydney Brown, and then we also have Aisha Brown on the court for UC San Diego to start the second half. Baxter takes it to the hoop, off the glass, no good. Rebound, Shearer.
Well, right there, Cochran changed that whole shot right there just by being strong with her length.
An opportunity down low, got a rebound. And now we have ourselves a jump ball. Correction. Foul on number 11, Aisha Brown. Her third personal, the first one on the Tritons this half. Cochran able to stay with it. Andrews against Montgomery, gets it up to Fowler, over to Shearer in the corner. And off of Andrews, smiling as she walks away.
Great extra pass right there. I like that three-point shot. They're just not knocking him down right now.
Shearer is in foul trouble. She's got three of them already. Cochran, just a presence down low on the block, redirecting the entire outcome of that shot. Montgomery looked like she got her ankle rolled up on. She went to go save that ball.
Well, Cochran's got such a long, you know, wingspan. Great job of just holding ground and, you know, making them alter their shot, and just threw it right into her hands right there.
Here's another look at that loose ball. Whistle off the ball. And the foul looks to be on number 12, Madison Baxter. That'll be her first and the second on UC San Diego.
Two quick fouls in the quarter.
Shearer can't connect.
Well, and they've literally done that almost every single time out of bounds. It's just defense isn't quite ready, and they just snuck it right over the top.
They'll have another opportunity here. Cochran near the elbow. Hand off to Andrews. The hesitation inside, the give and go. And a turnover.
Too many people in the lane right there. She needed, you know, was trying to thread the needle, needed to kick that out.
I was going to say, it seemed like there was a lot of traffic in the paint.
Yep.
Baxter. Offensive rebound, Montgomery, and Cochran over the top will get called for the foul.
Yeah, unfortunate right there. She got caught behind, and it looked pretty clean from where I'm at, but, you know, just out of position a little bit.
Her first, Portland's first in the third quarter. Montgomery 2 for 2 from the line already. 5.5 points and 1.9 rebounds last season for the Tritons. Played in all 15 games.
She's been very active for him tonight. I expect, you know, with the new season, her role is going to be changed a little bit more active.
Moheim to take. You can say she's on the ground. Foul on number 15, Brianna Quaros. Her third personal, the third one on UC San Diego. Again, the Pilots trying to do too much, trying to,
yep.
A couple passes now in the paint, trying to find a small window. Sydney Brown going up against Alex Fowler, picks up the foul.
Yeah, just trying to force it a little bit too much inside.
Second personal on Fowler, the second one on the Pilots in this quarter.
We've had a lot of fouls called in this first minute and a half.
Five fouls between the two teams. Brown originally transferred from Columbia. Averaged 14.3 points per game last season, 8.7 rebounds. That led the Big West. Pilots running their offense, gives it up to Andrews. No loop pass to Fowler, steps behind the three-point line, short. Baxter rebound for the Tritons. Obufege! In transition.
Yeah, that was a nice finish, nice catch. Good heads-up play. I feel like right now Portland's a little bit out of sync offensively. Just got to get some better flow and get some more opportunities, maybe move the ball a little bit more.
No points so far in the third quarter. Andrews in the paint, kicks it out to Shearer. 12 on the shot clock. Fowler the screen. Andrews driving, going to take it herself. No good. And a foul called. Foul called on number 12, Madison Baxter. That'll be her second personal, and the fourth one on UC San Diego. And the Tritons are going to have to be careful. The next foul gives Portland five, and that's two free throws.
And that's a lot of time left in the quarter to be in the bonus. You know, again, offensive flow right there. You know, yes, she got herself to the free throw line, but I didn't really like that offensive take.
And you're right, it seems like nothing has really been in the right spot for the Pilots to start this half.
Yeah.
Andrews knocks down both. 7 points on the evening, 4 assists. Tritons through the press. Obufege trying to put up a quick basket. And it looks like Haley Andrews will be called for the foul. That'll be her second, third one on the Pilots.
And UC San Diego's doing a better job of pushing the ball up the side, getting the ball up the floor quicker, and not putting it on the ground. And they've gotten themselves opportunities in transition and at the free throw line.
Obufege, a transfer from Virginia Tech. 3.6 points and 2.5 rebounds with the Hokies. 2 for 2 from the free throw line.
That's a nice transfer coming in for you. She's got good size.
Probably a great spot for her in the Big West and with the Tritons. Fowler backing down the defender in the paint, converting for two.
Again, just so strong.
She leads all scorers with 13 points. Montgomery flying through the pressure and the quick basket. Cochran kicks it out. Fowler going up against Sydney Brown. Shearer puts up a three. Halfway down and out.
Cochran does a really nice job of finding the guard opposite, which is usually what's open. Just nice patience. Kick the ball out. Saw Alex go down. Thank goodness she's okay there.
That'll be her third personal foul, so she'll be checking out of the game. Molheim checks out as well. Burnham and Kai Tu'u check in. Fowler and Shearer, both with three fouls each now.
Well, Shearer coming back from a little bit of an injury here. You know, I think she's pretty excited to get going and get in the game and got a little too handsy.
Obufege behind Sydney Brown. She just seems late on that whole possession.
Yep.
22-point lead for the Pilots. Cochran loses it. Montgomery able to get it away from her.
Well, I feel like Cochran, you know, like when she's got when she's been put in a position down low just to catch and shoot, she's done a great job. When she's had to put it on the ground, that's where she struggled a little bit.
Gets the steal here. Andrews to Shear, near wing. Long, Kaitu'u cleans it up. Kaitu'u with 5 points.
Good offensive board there, nice little putback.
Foul called on Emmy Shear. That's her fourth personal. And Rose Flug will now check in. And the 15th foul, that means UC San Diego is getting two free throws now.
Both teams on the next foul are going to be in the bonus for the rest of the half. You know, which kind of takes what Portland wants to do away. And the fact that they can't put as much pressure because they're getting called for stuff.
Baxter's first free throw attempt, no good. Senior from Pleasanton, California. Somebody who's played sparingly over the last couple of seasons here, 0 for 2. Travel on Bridget Mullings. It's now 16 turnovers for UC San Diego in today's contest. Burnham in the paint, kicks it out to Fluke. Got Claros to go by, and the mid-range jumper falls.
Well, super smart. Rose just checked into the game. You know, she didn't hit a three in the first half, and instead of pulling that, put it on the ground and shot a little mid-range jumper, which just smart basketball.
Chamberlain and the Tritons get a quick bucket. ...52-28, Pilots leading here in the third quarter, 5 minutes left to go. And Andrews fouled. Baxter is the one who will pick up that foul. That'll be her third personal. And it was a shooting foul, so Andrews will head to the line. And that'll bring us to immediate break. 5 minutes left to go in the third quarter, 52-28. Pilots leading by 24 on the WCC Network. Welcome back inside the Chow Center. 24-point lead for the Portland Pilots over UC San Diego. Brian Slack and Jennifer Mountain with your call. Here's a look at Haley Andrews. 7 points, 5 assists, 2 rebounds on the day. Some would consider almost the lifeblood of this offense. She sets up everything for Portland, and she's done a great job. She was a freshman here on campus running this offense.
She's a really, really smart point guard, strong, makes things happen as a leader. I mean, she can score in a variety of ways. I mean, we've seen it her whole career, and, you know, expect her to have a great, great year for them this season.
2 for 2 from the free throw line. She now has 9 points. Claro in trouble. Burnham couldn't get the steal. And Rose Flug Looks like she may pick up a foul. She will. That'll be her second personal and the sixth one on the Pilots.
I think Vernon thought she had a pick six right there. A little safety in football, basically. Came out of nowhere. But that's, again, what she's going to provide. Defensive pressure and intensity and just smart athleticism.
Forsyth checks in for the Tritons. Katie Springs, freshman from San Jose, California, at the line. Springs has only played for a total of 1 minute in today's contest. Burnham, the rebound.
Well, and right now, I mean, UC San Diego is playing them even this quarter. You know, coming out in the half and fighting, I love it.
Especially after a slow start. They started out down 14 to nothing in today's game. Forsyth getting it down to Springs, and Burnham again baiting the pass with the steal, but can't finish with the left hand. Flew there to clean it up.
Great job of anticipating. I think she just took off a little too soon.
Andrews going baseline, finishing. She's now got double-digit points at 11. Springs out to Forsyth. Cochran with the rebound. Blue picks up the dribble, gives it up to Andrews. Hard take and the block from Forsyth.
Great block.
It'll stay with the Pilots. 15 on the shot clock. Fluke letting the offense set up. Kaitu'u near the elbow. And now we've got a foul called.
Well, really nice job of recognizing the mismatch. Obviously had the size advantage. You could hear Coach Meek calling it from the sideline, and they did a nice job of adjusting really fast.
Courtney Thompson picked up the foul. Burnham will go to the line. Lindsay checked in for the Pilots along with Keely Frawley, and now it'll be Maddie Molheim. Springs checked out for UC San Diego. Checking in was Aisha Brown. Now after all the substitutions, Burnham ready to go at the line. She now is in double digits with 10 points.
Well, and you bring in the substitutions here. You've added three-point specialist, person on the ball that just makes things happen in Frawley. Lindsay, point guard, you know, can shoot the three, and Kaitu'u just, you know, same thing. She's got range outside, can play inside, and, you know, doesn't really drop off.
I was going to say, with Kaitu'u, with how she plays on the block and in the paint, almost deceiving with her size. She's got good feet down there and able to create some things.
Great take by Chamberlain right there. Nice little kiss off the glass.
Kaitu'u with it. 15 on the shot clock. Just under 3 minutes to go in the quarter. Lindsay, tough take, no call. Brown, rebound. Chamberlain gives it up to Thompson. Into Aisha Brown. No good. Rebound for the Pilots. Burnham looking up court, trying to make a play. Picks up her dribble, gives it up to Kaitu'u. Slapped away by Aisha Brown.
She wanted that foul.
And the transition bucket off the turnover. And a technical. We'll see who they call the technical on.
I think they called it on Lindsay.
The referees are discussing it right now. And it had to be some type of verbal cue, right? I didn't see anything, no physicality that might have caused an issue. and I didn't see much there. Maybe Brown had a slight elbow nudge of Lindsay underneath, but I didn't see much there that would have picked up a technical.
Did they say who the technical is on?
Portland foul is on number 32, Kelsey Lindsay, for second. We also have an intentional foul on UC San Diego's number 11, Aisha
okay,
Brown.
Okay, so it's on Aisha Brown.
I don't know. I might want to look at that one again if
and
I were the refs. Just kind of, I mean,
Brown.
I didn't really feel like she pushed her too much.
No, not at all. I mean, if anything, it was...
like her body just was going in the right direction.
It's Brown at the free throw line. 71% from the stripe last season.
No. Yeah, the basket was good, so there's only one shot there.
And now the Pilots will get an opportunity after the flagrant. Moheim making the free throw. 72.4% last season. 2 for 2 from the stripe. Here's another look, different angle.
Yeah. I mean, you can see her arm go. I honestly, like, I don't think there was an intent at all with
mm-hmm.
that. So, you know, different angle, I guess.
Moheim, the inbound. Two minutes ago in the third quarter. Burnham, strong take, foresight there on the defense. Now she's in trouble near the corner. Mullings gives it up to Montgomery.
Oh.
Wow, what a play by Montgomery to tip back in.
She's done a nice job for them tonight. Certainly not back down at all. Taking it at them, scored in a couple different ways, and nice heads up little tip right there.
She's now tied for the team high. She has the team lead at 9 points now. And a foul called on number 24, Bridget Mulling. Mulling's second personal foul.
And again, I mean, they've come out and played this quarter even with Portland so far. So, you know, kudos for the fact that they're competing really hard and not backing down whatsoever with the deficit.
Flug in, Moheim, correction, Lindsay out. Lucy Cochran will check in after the free throws. 60-34, Portland leading. Miss for Kai Tu. Nearly a 60% free throw shooter makes the second. Portland has not had a field goal in the last 2.5 minutes.
Yeah, they just haven't been in a too good of a rhythm on the offensive end. I mean, they've gotten opportunities to score, but just not as polished as they've been.
Chamberlain in trouble. That's a dangerous spot to pick up your dribble.
Yep.
Rowley on defense. Cuts off Chamberlain behind the back, and a foul call. And it looks to be on Maisie Burnham. And that'll be her third personal foul, the eighth on the Pilots.
At the line is number 2, Ula Chamberlain.
Ula Chamberlain to the line, 4 points in today's contest, 2 rebounds. Chamberlain has played against UP before. She was at Weber State a couple of seasons ago, put up 9 points, 4 rebounds, and 3 steals against the Pilots. Makes the free throw.
Yep, Oregon girl coming home.
Absolutely, from Ashland, Oregon. Graduate of South Medford High School. Burnham looking to give the ball up. Moheim double team. The Pilots Almost got it all the way around. Cochran making a move, able to split the defenders using the glass.
That was better body control and finish for her when putting it on the ground. I like to see that.
Courtney Thompson in trouble. Pass to Chamberlain and a foul called. And now it's going to be on Lucy Cochran. That'll be her second personal foul. Chamberlain will go back to the line.
Two hand touch. I mean, as soon as you put two hands on, it's an easy call for him. Not a big fan of it if it's not really displacing him, but it is the rule.
Chamberlain, an 84% free throw shooter.
Returning for the Pilots, number 10, Haley Andrews.
Makes that free throw. Haley Andrews checking back in. Rose Flug to the bench. And we saw her, I believe she got the start in the exhibition game, did some nice things, and Coach Meek really proud of how she's grown just in the last season alone. Travel called on Andrews. And you mentioned it early in the broadcast. Could she make that transition from the practice plays into game plays? And so far today, she's done a nice job of that.
She has. She's come in and contributed, you know. And again, it's her leadership as well. She's just a smart player, plays hard.
Rowley, the take all the way, the left-hand finish. Rowley picking up her first points. Moheim with the rebound. Bowling pokes it away. Got an offensive rebound and then is fouled with 19.3 seconds left on the clock. Keely Frawley will pick up that foul, her first, and the 10th one on the Pilots in this quarter.
Well, nice job by Mullins, just staying with the play, being aggressive, got her hands in there, got herself another opportunity.
Missed the free throw. Mullins, a freshman from Phoenix, Arizona, 55% free throw shooter, two-time first team all-region in high school. And that one in and out. Pilots trying to push a lead to almost 30 if they can make a basket here. 7 seconds, five, four. Kicks it out to Maisie Burnham. The shot fake. She's got to go quickly. Lost control of it. It's up and it's down. They're counting it. Coach Vanderveer not happy with it. And I didn't know if Burnham was going to get that one off. She lost control of it just underneath the hoop. But she makes it count. A 30-point lead for the Pilots. 67-37 on the WCC Network. Welcome back inside the Child Center. 30-point lead for the Pilots, thanks to Maisie Burnham. She's now tied with the team lead, 13 points, 6 rebounds. And what is considered her Pilot debut, the first game of the season. And Portland putting a hurting on UC San Diego.
Got to give credit, though, to UC San Diego. I mean, that quarter much better, 23-19. Came out and competed, did some good things. Both teams really struggling from the three-point line. There's only been 2 of 22 for the game for both teams.
And those two both came from the Pilots. Molheim losing it. And they called a charge. So Molheim will pick up her second personal foul and the first one for Portland in this quarter.
You know, and that's one thing Coach Meek talked about, turnovers. I mean, a charge is a turnover. It's going the other way. And, you know, again, just trying to maybe go a little bit too fast and make things happen so early in the shot clock.
Going to dry off the court. I mean, points off of turnovers, the Pilots have done a nice job. They've converted the 18 turnovers into 21 points. And, you know, I'm sure Coach Meek's still not happy with the 14 turnovers that his team has. But for a team that was averaging up 16, 17, 18 last season, it's small improvement right now depending on how they can finish out this game.
Well, absolutely. And you look at the 38 points in the paint and 30 points from your bench, you're going to be pretty happy.
Forsythe to Chamberlain. Back to Forsythe, baseline. Got Fowler to Chase. Hangs on the lip, no good. And Cochran tips it around for the rebound. Shear thought she was open, streaking down the court.
Nice high-low.
And I don't know if she feels that pressure coming across, but the quick release sort of nullified that defender.
Well, I think that we're going to see that combination a lot this season. And I mean, what a great thing. I mean, it can go either way, whether it's pulling Fowler out or pulling her out.
The inbound for the Pilots, always dangerous.
Well, and Coach Meek talked about her passing skills, and he wasn't kidding.
She's got 3 assists, 12 rebounds, and 8 points right now for Cochran. She was strong, no good.
Emmy struggled to get herself into a flow tonight, and there she goes, picks up her 5th.
Her 5th personal foul. And that'll be it. Keely Frawley will check in for her. Sydney Brown also checks in along with Madison Baxter and number 15, Brianna Claros. Well, I know we were excited to see Emmy Shearer coming back. She didn't play in the exhibition game, sat out with an injury, but not the start to the season that she probably would have wanted. At one point, she had 4 fouls in 8 minutes and is now fouled out with just under 9 minutes left to go in the game.
Well, you know, that's, you know, first time under the lights, really. And you know, probably a little bit amped up, got herself out of position a few times. She's trying to make things happen, make plays for her team, and can't fault her for that. You just got to have a little bit better body control.
And she's somebody who showed a very big bright spot at the end of last year. Andrews, the 3, no good. Frawley goes up for the rebound.
Oh, I'm not worried about Shear whatsoever. I mean, she can bring a lot to this team, and she can score in a variety of different ways, and she's super athletic.
Sewell gives it up to Fowler, who bodied off Chamberlain, and the finish off the glass.
Again, nice high-low action with Fowler down low. Good pass from the high post.
Emily Sewell checking into the game. Fowler gets the steal. The passing from the Pilots is crisp and count the basket. Coach Vandeveer calling a timeout. And we have a timeout on the floor. 73-37. No. It's 73-37. Pilots leading in the fourth quarter. with just under 8 minutes left to go. And here's a look at that last turnover.
That's just great court vision by Andrews right there, knowing she's there. Nice little quick touch pass.
Going to some of the practices when they were first allowed to in the fall, one of the things that Coach Meek talked about was always keeping your eye on the ball. And it's exactly for plays like that, where Maddie just had to turn around and it was a perfect pass from Andrews to her and the easy finish underneath. And that's what it means to always keep your eye on the ball.
Oh, for sure. And again, just Andrews is just, she has such great court vision. Knew exactly where to go with that ball before it even entered her hands. And that's, you know, if you look at that play right there, and that's exactly what UC San Diego doesn't want to do in that quick turnover, especially in the backcourt, just an easy two going the other way. And, you know, good time out there by Coach Vandeveer to get their squad back in check and compete like they did in that third quarter.
The Pilots are ready to go. UC San Diego still talking things over in their huddle. 7 points for Maddie Moheim. And an assist, 3 for 3 from the field today. And she's made some nice moves. We've only seen her shoot that 1-3. Normally we're used to seeing probably 3 or 4 shots from behind the arc. But again, she pushed herself this offseason to try to add another facet to her game. And she's done a nice job of attacking the hoop.
Well, super smart, because she just becomes a different weapon. You know, everybody has played her as a 3-point shooter, scouts. I mean, that's what it was. She can shoot the three and she can shoot it deep. And now people have to defend her in multiple facets. So that's going to be a great thing for her moving forward through the season.
Guaros to Chamberlain. Triton's keeping it outside the 3-point line.
They do just such a nice job of being active in their zone defensively.
Brown going up against Emily Sewell. Around and out. Kai Tu'u with it. Moheim with range. Oh! From the pilot wheel.
Well, I said deep. And no joke there. My goodness, what range. And there wasn't a second thought about that.
No, not at all. Shooting. Oh, the bad pass to Brown takes her out of bounds and a turnover.
Returning for the Pilots, number 32, Kelsey Lindsay.
Coach Vandeveer a bit frustrated with her team's performance, especially in the first half. But you're right, in that third quarter, coming out here in the second half is much more of what she wanted out of her squad. And they played a lot tougher.
Absolutely. You just don't want to have a turnover like that, you know.
And a 3-second violation.
Second
time that's been called tonight.
Well, I mean, that's going to be something probably moving forward we may see a little bit more of, just because they've got more post presence.
Sydney Brown in the paint. And they're going to count that one. Rose Pflug will pick up the foul. That'll be her third personal and the third one on the Pilots. As Kai Tu'u checks out, Burnham back in. Here's another look at it.
I don't know.
I just thought that was a strong take by Brown.
Nice take by Brown. She's been very aggressive. She hasn't finished as probably as much as she'd like, but she's been really aggressive to the rim, which down the road I think could be a really good thing for them.
She now has 10 points, leading UC San Diego. Turnover, Portland. Brown can't finish inside. Got her own rebound and fouled. She'll head back to the line.
She's very aggressive and athletic, and I mean, doesn't have a ton of size, but enough size. Make things happen, and again, another nice little take.
Kelsey Lindsay picks up the foul. That's her second. Brown making the free throw. You talked about her not finishing as well. She had like 4 for 14 on the day.
Yeah, I think that first quarter she had quite a few opportunities where she just went way too fast. and miss some easy ones that she probably, you know, on a normal day doesn't miss. She's settled down real nice here in the second half.
Brown going up against a freshman and Burnham paws that one down. Brawley brings it across the timeline, foul called.
And UC San Diego's bringing the same kind of pressure that they've had to face right back at Portland, and it's caused a little bit of issues here in the last minute.
Maisie Burnham right there, getting her hand on it and denying Brown as Sydney Brown picks up her second personal foul. First one on UC San Diego in the quarter. Just over 6 minutes left to go in our contest. Kicks it out to Flug. Can't connect on that three. Frawley hits the deck.
Frawley plays hard.
She does. That's something that she's been doing since she got on campus a couple of seasons ago, and the coaches really like that energy. She's not somebody who's going to pour in, you know, 12, 15 points for you, but she does all the little things that the coaches love.
And honestly, she has the ability to score, so, I mean, you know, you never know what can happen. But she's that energy player off the bench and rebounds like crazy.
Claro's got Flug to go by her. Off the mark, though. Frawley gives it up to Lindsay. The Pilots get it across the timeline. And the crossover out of her reach. Turnover, Portland. Liana Kaituu checking in. Emily Sewell will head to the bench.
But one of the things Coach Meek talked about the other day, too, is just the ball handling. There's a great example right there. You just can't afford that turnover. In a game like this where you got a big point spread, you're fine. But in a close game, those types of turnovers are going to kill you.
And Kelsey Lindsay poking the ball away from Alex Obufege. Skip pass to Burnham. Going by Montgomery. Puts a shoulder down and finish off the glass. 15 now for Maisie Burnham.
She's got a quick first step, and man, when she goes, she goes. She goes to finish hard.
I was gonna say, there's no hesitation from her. As Obufege gets fouled, she'll head to the line for two. And Rose Flug will pick up that foul. And that'll send us to the media break. 4:54 left to go in the contest. 78-41, the Pilots working with a 37-point lead inside the Child Center. We'll be right back on the WCC Network. Welcome back inside the Child Center. Alex Obufege to the free throw line. Brian Slyke and Jennifer Mountain with your call. Obufege with 4 points and four rebounds today. Pilots looking to close out this game with a 37-point lead right now.
Well, and if you're Coach Meek right now, you really want just a solid last 5 minutes here. You don't want to get sloppy. You've still got a lot of people in the rotation, getting some new combinations maybe out on the floor, get some people that have been injured in the ball game, but just want to be solid.
Well, four players now in double digits for the Pilots, and a jump ball called. Possession arrow towards the Tritons. And Keely Frawley not exactly pleased with that call.
That's good job by UC San Diego coming right at him with the pressure. And honestly, the last minute and a half, it's really caused some issues for Portland.
Emily Sewell checking in. Liana Kaitu'u to the bench. Quaros over Sewell. Fluke in trouble, gives it up to Lindsay. Cross court to Frawley. I'm trying to give it up to Maisie Burnham, but Obufege with the hands and the turnover.
That's maybe one she should have taken herself. I mean, I like the idea of the extra pass. Sometimes you can overpass.
And Rose Flug has just picked up her fourth personal foul. So she is in foul trouble. Kaitu'u checking back in. Keely Frawley to the bench. Parker Montgomery, 3 for 4 from the three free throw line today. 9 points, second on the team in scoring this afternoon. Full court pressure put on UC San Diego, or by UC San Diego. And I didn't see who they called the foul on.
Foul, number 12,
Madison Baxter picks up the foul, so she's now in trouble with four. Kaitu'u near the corner, gives it up to Lindsay. The defender flies by. Emily Sewell on the three-point line, gets her first points in a Pilot uniform.
And again, a player that's got some size, that's got a little bit of range. I mean, nice mid-range shot. And
I mean, one player we haven't seen that we saw in the exhibition, she won't be playing today, is MJ Bruno, and she's somebody that also has got some good size on her and good athletic ability, is Liana Kaitu'u. Smart move, taps out the ball to Flug. Keeps the ball alive. Lindsay thought she had the move on Montgomery, turns it over.
Yeah, and the one thing they're doing is they're trying to put it on the ground a little bit too much. Maybe just beat this press by pass and advance quickly.
Obufege to Montgomery, near wing. Back to Obufege in the paint. No call. Kaitu'u, and the Pilots turn it over. Sydney Brown turns it into two.
And Brown. Right now it's the ball handling that's causing issues for Portland.
And they stepped over the end line, inbounding the ball on another turnover for Portland, and that's just a mental mistake.
Absolutely. And one that Coach Meek's not going to be very happy about. I mean, this is something that they've been talking about, is taking care of the ball and not turning it over. And in the last few minutes here, just too many turnovers.
Montgomery had a shot, the hit back iron. And again, the Tritons causing trouble off the rebound. Sewell gives it up to Frawley. Numbers gives it up to Lindsay, and Obufege, hard foul on Kelsey Lindsay. Obufege picks up her first personal foul. That'll be the fourth one on UC San Diego. Lindsay will head to the line for two.
You know, right now Portland's got 20 turnovers for the game, and thought in the first half they did a really nice job of taking care of it. It's gotten a little bit sloppy here towards the end. And, you know, again, it's hard to keep yourself totally dialed in when you have this kind of a lead, but, you know, that's going to be something that they talk about for sure.
Kelsey Lindsay making the first free throw. And minimal attempts, made all of her attempts last season. And continues that streak into this year. Thompson back in, Springs as well for UC San Diego, and the pass through Forsyth's hands.
Well, that was a bullet. Got to put a little bit more touch and give your teammate a chance to catch that one.
Almost took her head off.
Yep.
Crowley doing her best quarterback impression all the way down the court. Fluke gets the defenders to go by in the bucket. Crowley cuts off Baxter, gets the steal. Pilots have numbers. Burnham has it. Dribbles inside, and a charge. Courtney Thompson on the receiving end of it.
She got herself caught in the air right there. Just a smart defensive play. Just took it. Looks like she got her elbow a little bit too.
Burnham picks up her fourth foul. So both Maisie Burnham and Rose Pflug in foul trouble in the final 2 minutes and 15 seconds. Right now for UC San Diego, only 9 points on the floor. Forsyth puts it up. All backboard, Lindsay on the rebound. Crowley putting up the three, connecting!
Oh, and that's what I was talking about. I mean, she can do a little bit of everything. She can shoot it, she can make things happen defensively, get it out in the break, and she's strong and has some size.
Overall, just her competitive nature.
For sure.
I think really drives her and the rest of her teammates. She just has that certain type of energy. Sewell on defense on Springs.
And Sewell got caught behind there. You got to either three-quarter or get around her. You give, you know, post of any you know, 2 feet from the block, you're going to be in trouble.
Pilots keeping it outside. Now it's Sewell near the low block. Went baseline, off the glass.
Nice little patient move there.
Courtney Thompson dribbles it out, now goes baseline, lost control of it. Crowley ends up with it. Final minute of play. 89-48, that's a 41-point lead for Portland. They put up a great showing in the home opener. Lindsay driving and capped it off with two. Pilots with 91. Forsyth near the block. No good. Sewell rebound. And almost turned it over. Ooh, a Chamberlain was there.
She almost turned that one over.
Pilots can just dribble out the clock as the final 7 seconds tick away. 91-48, and the Pilots victorious in the season opener and put on quite the show inside the Child Center. And even better, the Pilots ended the game 6-for-6 from the field, and that's how you finish strong.
And they did a nice job of, you know, staying with it. We talked about, you know, coming out and just maintaining that. In the fourth quarter, I thought they did a better job than they did in the third of just kind of breaking it open a little bit. Turned the ball over a little bit too much, but got some different combinations in there and some attempts that are going to certainly help them down the road.
Yeah, you talk about the turnovers. They forced 25, but again, 21 turnovers on their own. The three-point line was not really their friend, but because of how efficient they were in the paint tonight is really what made the difference. I mean, in the paint, it was 52 points for Portland to just 24 for UC San Diego. And then the bench points, getting the production off the bench was huge. We've been wondering where they were going to get that production, or the Pilots were going to get that production, and they certainly got it with four different players in double digits tonight.
Well, you have that many points, you know, the production off the bench combined with that points in the paint, you know, it really doesn't matter how well you shoot from the three-point line. I know that they're going to want to work on that a little bit, and it's not that they didn't take good three-point shots, just weren't falling this evening.
And now we welcome on Maisie Burnham, who's our player of the game. Maisie, you did a great job. You had 15 points, 6 rebounds, and 2 assists to go along with everything else. How did you feel in your first game out there with your teammates?
Obviously, coming in from the Big Sky, freshman of the year, there's some expectations, but what are your goals going into this weekend? Obviously, you got a great win today, but you got another one on Saturday. What can you learn from today moving forward? How about your transition from coming from Cheney into Portland? Obviously, different atmosphere, different club. How have you adjusted? Have you had a great time? And how do you like this team?
Well, Maisie, it's been a while since we had fans in the stands to watch a game. You haven't had that opportunity in your college career at Eastern Washington. They didn't have the fans last year. How is it to be back in front of them? All right, well, Maisie, thank you for your time and a terrific performance tonight, and best of luck the rest of the season. Well, that was Maisie Burnham. I'm Brian Slyke, and this is Jennifer Mountain. Jennifer, do you have any other final thoughts on today's contest?
No, I think Coach Meek's going to be really happy with that. You know, now it's, you know, learn from it and then move forward into Saturday. Got another opponent coming in. That's going to be a nice challenge for them, and they're going to learn a lot from it.
Well, if you're not tired of our voices yet, don't go anywhere. In the next 30 minutes, the men's tip off their home matchup against Willamette. In just a few minutes, we'll see you then on the WCC Network.